Welcome back. In this video, we're gonna be taking a look at SuiteAdvanced. Now, SuiteAdvanced is a third-party web browser extension that basically optimizes NetSuite's user interface and provides a lot of additional features. The people that benefit the most from SuiteAdvanced are ones that use NetSuite all the time, such as consultants and administrators. And while there's a lot of different features available with SuiteAdvanced, in this video, we're only gonna be taking a look at a few of the most commonly used features. So let's take a look at this. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is actually install this third-party app. So I'm here on my Chrome browser and I'm at Google. So I'm just gonna put in SuiteAdvanced. And you'll see it's the first thing that comes up here, SuiteAdvanced for NetSuite. So if you click on that, now if you haven't installed it already, it's gonna come to this page and it's gonna say download. In this case, I already have it, so it says remove. You simply click on that link. What's gonna happen is it'll download it in just a few seconds and a separate browser will open. It'll have some legal information that you have to read, you sign an agreement, and then at that point you can either access the free trial for SuiteAdvanced or you can pay for the subscription. Once you do that, it's gonna ask you for the email. Make sure you put in the email that's actually associated with your NetSuite account, and then an email is gonna go to that email address. You click on the link and it will basically verify that that is the correct email address, at which point you can simply log into your NetSuite and then you'll see exactly what I'm gonna show you here. So I do have NetSuite already open, so I'm gonna click on that. All right, so this browser has SuiteAdvanced on it, so we can see the changes pretty immediately. You'll notice over here, I've got the SuiteAdvanced logo. That's kind of like the home button for SuiteAdvanced. There's also a few cosmetic changes, such as you see these little drop-down arrows on the center, which basically show what actually has a drop-down, unlike analytics, which does not. But the first actual feature I wanna get to, we're gonna see it right over here. So we have this refresh all button and then this live view button. So what refresh all does is you notice on the portlets for your dashboard, they've got these refresh buttons. But if you wanna have everything updated, you'd have to go through and you have to click all your refreshes. By clicking this, it simply does the refreshes for all of them at once. So it's a handy way to just immediately have your entire dashboard get refreshed. However, if you wanna have it happen not on a manual basis, but you wanna have it just happen automatically, what you can do is go over to this logo for SuiteAdvanced and you go over this first SuiteAdvanced button and you'll see settings here. So if I click on that, and so we come to the settings page here. So let's scroll down a bit and we've got this timing section and you can actually kind of see it happening already in the background. Notice that every few seconds, this thing is updating. And we can see here, live view dashboard, 20 seconds. So every 20 seconds, this dashboard is automatically refreshing. You can see it happen right there. So if we set it to 5 seconds, in just a few seconds, it's automatically going to update everything. And you can do that for other things. Let's say you can see up here, there's list views. So if we close this, and I'm gonna turn this off for a second, and let's go to list. Let's just look at employees, for example. So it brings us to this list of employees. And you can see we also have the live view up here. And again, if you have lists that you're working with that you want to constantly have up to date, especially ones that have transactions or records that are constantly being updated to them, you might want to click this live view. That way, the list is constantly updating as you're working with it. So going back to our home dashboard, the other feature I wanna point out is if we click here and we go back to that settings window I just had open. So this is a really cool feature that comes with SuiteAdvanced, especially for people that have a hard time with all the bright white that comes along with NetSuite. We have this theme mode and we can set it to dark mode. And you can see that immediately changes everything to be dark. Programmers are gonna be pretty familiar with this type of setting. And it simply is easier on the eyes. So over long periods of time, studies have shown you're easier to look at something like this as opposed to an all white background. You can also set it to auto, which is basically going to trigger based on the quality of light around you. So whether it's daytime, nighttime, et cetera, the NetSuite will reflect what's occurring around you. In addition to just having those light mode, dark mode, you can also change the various colors that you're gonna see in NetSuite. Now, you're probably already familiar with that. If you go to the normal NetSuite settings for user preferences, you can set up to like green, red, I've shown that in the past. However, they only have a certain amount of colors that you can go with, and they tend to be single tone, meaning they'll have blue for everything or green for everything. So if you do wanna have something that's a little more customized for you, You can click on main color. It gives you this large color palette. So you can select, let's say purple, and you'll see it immediately updated. The primary color is purple, and we can set the secondary color to be something based on our preference. So in this case, I've selected purple and yellow. And I can simply go down to remove colors and take it back to zero. Now, this is maybe not as helpful, but kind of a funny feature. You can click on this rainbow and it will just automatically rotate through various colors you'll see here and in the background here. It'll just kind of cycle through things. So that's kind of a fun one to play around with. But we're gonna turn that off. So before I go off this page, we have these options here at the top. You'll see LinkedIn, YouTube, Twitter, etc. These are all just ways to contact the developer. And the reason for that is you can see here the version. There's a lot of different versions of SuiteAdvanced. There's new versions coming out all the time with new developments that are being added and new features. If there's something that you do, maybe like a repetitive process or some kind of user interface that you run into a lot that takes time or is a bit clunky with NetSuite, you can always suggest something to the developer, and he's very open to taking those suggestions and incorporating them into the next version completely free of charge. And I should comment that Super Training is not associated with SuiteAdvanced in any way, shape, or form, but it's such a useful extension that for the small fee that you pay every month as part of the subscription, all the features that you get and the updates that come routinely, it's a bit of a no-brainer. So the next feature I wanna show you, if we go to Documents, Files, we're gonna go to the File Cabinet. So if you've seen my other video on the File Cabinet or if you've ever had to use the File Cabinet, you know the system is incredibly out of date. It's not drag and drop friendly at all. It's clunky in terms of moving things around. So SuiteAdvanced has done a number of different changes to basically make the user interface far more accessible. So for example, if you want to add a file, we're gonna go down here, I have this folder, and I have a file here. So let's say I wanna add this image, I can grab it and simply drag it over my folders here. I can also take it specifically to folders, such as I have images over here. I can drop it there, and it pops up this window, and it was such a small image, it downloaded immediately, but the file will upload in real time. So if it's a larger file, you'll see the upload occurring. It'll give you updates on how that stands and it'll tell you when it's complete. So that's a nice feature there. You can also do things like add new folders. It pops up this little window. You can simply type in the folder name. Before you had to go to a whole nother page, put in all this information just to add a folder. You can drag and drop things. You've got this feature which copies the path to get to that file folder structure. So if you need to send that to another user, you have the ability to send them that exact file path. You have this folder tree, you can make it bigger, smaller, just a lot of things that got changed here to make this entire file cabinet much easier to use. So the last feature I'm gonna highlight is in regards to save searches. So the way to do that, if you wanna go to reports, you can do a save search through here, new search, but with SuiteAdvanced, you can go up to the icon here. And notice we have the new save search right here. So we've got the entire list down here. Let's say you want to start a transaction search. You can add that here, but you can also just click right there. It brings you to the ability to set what it is, but what it does, it automatically links you to this bar at the top. So from there, you can just immediately type in transaction. You can hit tab, and it immediately by hitting tab, it submits that. So if you wanna do, again, transaction save searches, by far the most common that you use, you can simply click on that button at the top. You go to, you hit T, transaction, you hit tab, it immediately brings you to this page. So you don't have to go through that long process just to get to a save search in the first place. It brings you right here. Now, once you're here, I'll give you another example of a common feature. So let's just set a mainline item. Yes. And let's set type for Bill. So now that we have that set, we'll go to results. Now I showed you in an earlier video that if we wanna add a formula, so we've added this currency formula. So if we go over here to the formula column here and we click on this little button, again, you'll be familiar with this from an earlier video I made, but we come to this. So this should look familiar up until this point. But at this point, if we wanna add a formula and we wanna add those field values, we have to click up here and we have to scroll through whatever field we want. But instead of having to click up there and then type and then click up there constantly, now what you can do is you can simply add the curly bracket and then type in the field that you want. And it does what that top bar, what that drop-down menu is already doing. So just by typing, it auto-selects the one you want. So in this case, amount, so we can close bracket that. And then we could add something else, let's say type. And it gives us that right there, so we can close bracket that. So it's just a much faster way, especially if you're doing a lot of formulas. Instead of clicking back and forth with the mouse constantly, you can simply type exactly what you need and it auto-fills them in. So we'll hit cancel on that. Another feature I wanna show you. So let's say we're good on this saved search. I've added some criteria. We've got some results already set. I'll hit okay on that. And I'm gonna go down here to save and run. So you should be familiar at this point by hitting save and run, it brings us to a page that shows us the results of this saved search. So we can see this. But now let's say we wanna go back to our results or criteria. We wanna change something, but we don't have to constantly go back and forth between this page and the search results and criteria. So instead we can go up here, we can hit split view. And you'll see by doing that, we now have our search and results up here. And we now have this split view where we can see the results of our saved search down here. So for example, if we wanted to, let's say, change mainline from true to no or false, we can now click preview on that. And it immediately updates, so we're not going back and forth, it just shows us now the results of that. So now we have mainline is off. And one last part of this that I wanna show you is we've got this run button. So in instances where you don't actually wanna save that save search, but you simply wanna be able to run it, you can click on this button, which is not available in the normal NetSuite instance, and it will give you that functionality. So those are just a few of the features that come with SuiteAdvanced that make things more efficient and altogether make your life easier. Again, there's dozens of different features that do come with SuiteAdvanced, as well as updates that come out regularly. So if those are things that are interesting to you, check out the free trial, and I'll see you in the next video.